Hey guys, hi, welcome back. So in the last video, we have discussed about the fundamental types of interactions. And in this video, we shall discuss about the classification of particles. So when we will discuss about the classification of particles, then we will discuss firstly on the basis of spin. And secondly, we will discuss on the basis of interaction. So when we are talking about spin, right? When we are talking about spin, so on the basis of spin, particles are classified as bosons, which are integer spin particles, and the second one is fermions, and these are half integer spin particles. So the first point is what? Bosons, they have integer spin. They have integer spin. And when we talk about fermions, then they have half integer spin. They have half integer spin. So integer spin means what? Integer spin means s is equals to 0, 1, 2, and so on. And when we are talking about half integer spin, then it means s is equals to 1 by 2, 3 by 2, and so on. Now let's see the example for bosons. So the example of bosons is what? For spin equals to 0, spin 0 particles are pions, they are kaons, and the next is eta. And spin 1 particles are photon. And in the last video, we have seen that gravitons are having what? Spin 2. These were the exchange particles in gravitational interaction, which was having spin 2. So graviton is a boson. Similarly, when we will see the example for fermions, then firstly, all the leptons. In the later part, we will see what are leptons. So all the leptons are what? Are fermions. So this is the first thing that you have to see. Second, omega, lambda. Again, we can see proton, neutron, neutrino, electrons. So these are fermions. They are having spin half. All right. The third point is that bosons, they do not follow the Pauli's exclusion principle. So they do not follow Pauli's exclusion principle. But fermions, they do follow the Pauli's exclusion principle. So we will write, they follow Pauli's exclusion principle. Next is about the statistics they follow. So bosons, they follow Bose-Einstein statistics. All right. They follow Bose-Einstein statistics. And in case of fermions, they follow the Fermi-Dirac statistics. So we write, they follow Fermi-Dirac statistics. So this is all about the fermions and the bosons. We have classified the particles on the basis of spin. They are bosons and fermions. Bosons are having spin integer and fermions are having half integer spin. S equals to 0, 1, 2 is the integer spin. Half 3 by 2 is the half integer spin, right? And the example of bosons are photon, graviton, pions, kaons, and so on. And in case of fermions, all the leptons are fermions. Proton, neutron, muon, omega, lambda, these all are fermions. And bosons, they do not follow the Pauli's exclusion principle. But when we talk about fermions, they are following Pauli's exclusion principle. When we talk about bosons, they are following the Bose-Einstein statistics, but the fermions follow the Fermi-Dirac statistics. Now we know what is Pauli's exclusion principle. It means that no two electrons in an atom can occupy the same energy state simultaneously, right? So two fermions, they are what? They are not allowed to occupy the same quantum state, while bosons can be in the same quantum state. Two bosons are allowed to occupy the same quantum state, but fermions are not allowed. All right. So this is all about the classification of the particles on the basis of spin. Now we will see on the basis of interaction. The second is what? On the basis of interaction. So now you see, on the basis of interaction, the particles are classified as leptons, and the second is what? Hadrons. It is what? On the basis of interaction, all right? It is classified as what? Leptons, right? Leptons are having spin half, remember? And the second one is what? Hadrons. All right? So, all the leptons are fermions, I have already said. Now you see, on the basis of interaction, it is classified. So, which interactions are followed by leptons, while which interactions are followed by hadrons? So, when we see about leptons, they do not participate in strong interaction. So, leptons, we will write here what? They do not participate. They do not participate in strong interaction, right? This is one exception of the leptons. Now, leptons are participating in which interactions? They participate in electromagnetic and weak interaction. They participate in electromagnetic and weak interaction, right? When we talk about hadrons, then they participate in strong electromagnetic and weak interaction, right? They participate in all the three interactions. They participate, this is for hadrons, they participate in electromagnetic, strong, and weak interaction, right? Now we will see the example for leptons. So the example for leptons is what? Electron, right? The second one is what? Tau. The third one is muon. All right? The third one is muon. All right? Now you see, electron's antiparticle is what? Electron neutrino. Electron neutrino, right? For tau it is what? Mu. For tau it is tau neutrino, right? For tau it is what? Tau neutrino. And for muon it is what? It is muon neutrino, right? So all the neutrinos are also leptons. Electron, tau and muon, these are also leptons. Now we will see the example of what? We will see the example for hadrons. All right. So you see, hadrons are further classified, you can say, further classified as what? Mesons and baryons. It is classified further as mesons and baryons, you can say. Right. So if you talk about what? Mesons. Then mesons are having what? Mesons are having spin 0, 1, 2, 3, right? Mesons are having spin what? Spin is 0, 1, 2, 3, all right? Means they are bosons, all right? And when we talk about baryons, then they are having what? They are having spin half, 3 by 2, and so on. Clear? So in mesons, we are having what? The examples of mesons will be what? Pions, right? Second is what? Kaons. The third is eta. Pions is plus minus zero. All right. This will be what? Clay plus minus zero. And eta is eta zero. So these all are what? Mesons. Now we will see about baryons. So baryons I'm writing in the next page. All right. I'm writing baryon in the next one. So the baryons are what? Baryons are further classified as what? They are further classified as nucleons and hyperons. All right. Baryons are further classified as nucleons and hyperons. So we know nucleons are having what? More lifetime. So when we talk about lifetime, they are having what? More lifetime. Nucleons are having more lifetime, but hyperons, they are having what? Less lifetime. All right. Now nucleons, we know proton and neutron, right? Nucleons are made up of what? Protons and neutrons, right? Next, in case of hyperons, what will be there? in hyperence we will have what? Sigma, right? It is sigma plus minus, right? Next we will have what? We will have xi. So xi is also what? Minus and zero. Next you will have here lambda. Next we are having here what? Lambda. So lambda zero. And after that we will have what? Omega. Then we are having omega, right? So these all are hyperons. Sigma, xi, lambda and omega. And when we are talking about nucleons, then they are protons and neutrons. Clear? So this is the classification of the particles on the basis of interactions. They are classified as leptons and hadrons. Leptons are spin half particles, right? When we talk about hadrons, it is having both spin of integer spin also, and it is having half integer spin also. So leptons, they do not follow or they do not participate in strong interaction, but they do participate in electromagnetic and weak interaction. Hadrons are participating in all the three interaction. Now the examples of leptons are electron, tau and muon and neutrino. When we talk about hadrons, hadrons are further classified as mesons and baryons. Mesons are having spin integer and baryons are having half integer. So the mesons are pions, kaons and eta. And when we talk about baryons, baryons are further classified as nucleons and hyperons, right? Remember, the spin will be half integer only. All right, the spins are half integer only. The only difference is that nucleons are having more lifetime, but when we talk about hyperons, then they are having less lifetime. Nucleons means proton and neutron. We have already studied that nucleons are made up of what? Protons and neutrons. And when we talk about hyperons, then hyperons are sigma, xi, lambda and omega. Clear? Next, one more topic which is very important and that will be used multiple number of times when we will be studying particle physics, that is particle and antiparticle. These two terms we need to know, particles and antiparticles. So first of all, we will see what is particle and what is antiparticle, means the simple difference between particle and antiparticle. The first thing that you have to remember here is that antiparticles, they are having the same symbol except a bar over particle, right? We will write antiparticles have the same symbol, have the same symbol as particle except a bar over it, right? If I'm writing proton, suppose I'm taking an example. I denote proton by P. This is the particle, right? And if I write the antiparticle of proton, then I will denote it as what? P bar, right? So this is the difference between particle and antiparticle. Now we will see when we will solve problems, we need to know there are some quantities which is same for both particle and antiparticle, and there are some quantities which are different. So first we will see the particles that are same, the quantities that are same, right? The quantities that are same, right? Same for both the particle and antiparticle. So they are having the same rest mass. Remember, they will have the same spin. They will have the same lifetime. They will have same isospin. They will have the same isospin. This is I. So these are the four quantities which is same for both the particles and antiparticles: rest mass, spin, lifetime and isospin. So the quantities that are different, that will be what? We will see quantities that are different, all right, for particles and antiparticles. So particles and antiparticles, which quantities are different, we will see is that first thing is the third component of isospin, right? I3. That is the third component of isospin. So this is what it is different. Next is what? Next is the charge. Charge is also different. It will be opposite, right? If a particle is having plus one charge, antiparticle will have minus one charge. Next will be what? Lepton number. Next is what? lepton number. Also, the baryon number is different. Baryon number is different. Strangeness is also different. Strangeness is also different, right? Quantum number is also different. Quantum number is also different. Next is the magnetic dipole moment. So these are the quantities which are different in case of particle and antiparticle. The third component of isospin, I3, lepton number, baryon number, strangeness, quantum number, magnetic dipole moment and charge, right? So these all the quantities are what? Different for these cases. Next, what we will see, how we can see the parity, right? So when you will see that particle and antiparticle, right, they have opposite parity. What will they have? They will have opposite parity, right? Fermions will have opposite parity. Bosons will have what? Bosons and antibosons, they will have same parity. All right, they may have opposite parity. Bosons may have, will have what? Same parity. I will write the third point is about parity. They may have opposite parity, right? When you talk about bosons and antibosons, right? For bosons and antibosons, boson and antibosons have same parity. Clear? But when we talk about fermions, fermions and antifermions have opposite parity. They are having opposite parity. Now, when we are calculating the parity in case of what? In case of particles, then we are using the formula. This is only for antiparticle, okay? Only for particle, this is not for antiparticle. Only for particle, the parity is equals to what? Parity is given by minus 1 to the power 2s plus 1, right? This you can use only for particle and just take the opposite, that will be for antiparticle. Now for suppose I am considering for what? If we check for boson, right? We know the example of boson is what? Kaon is a boson, right? So if I take kaon, I'm giving an example, right? We will solve this is for bosons. If I consider what? K negative, right? So we know the spin is what? The spin is zero. Kaons are having spin how much? The spin for kaon is zero. So if I calculate the parity for kaon, parity is equals to minus 1 to the power what? 2s, so it is 0, 1. So the parity is what? Minus 1. So what will happen? Its antiparticle will also have what? Antiparticle K plus will have what? Parity minus 1. But similarly, if you see for fermion, if I consider one fermion, for example, if I consider what? In case of fermion, if I consider electron, okay. So if I'm considering electron, right? Electrons are having spin what? Spin is half. So the parity will be what? Parity will be minus 1 to the power 2, 1 by 2 plus 1. So the parity is what? Plus 1, right? So its antiparticle will have what? Its antiparticle will have parity minus 1. So this is how you can calculate. So this will be used while doing questions. These things will come. And one more thing, when we will do questions, you will see sometimes you will see about what? Subconservations and all these things you will see. Then in that case, when you will have particles and antiparticles, then you have to remember which quantities are same and which quantities are not same. So you have to put stress in that also. And sometimes you might have questions related to what? Lifetimes also, when you are talking about baryons. So you can remember the baryon numbers when you remember what? That which are particles are baryons, right? Similarly for mesons also, we have seen here what is the spin. So this way it will help you. Just see the proper classifications, because this classification is on the basis of spin, on the basis of lifetime also we have seen, in between also we have seen on the basis of interaction. So you might get a lot of questions related to this, but the only things that you should remember in a proper way, the order of means your memory should be like in a proper arrangement, otherwise everything will get meshed. When you will understand these things and it will be very crystal clear for you, then you can attempt a lot of questions, because the questions patterns in nuclear is like different. All right, so that's all in this video. Thank you so much. Have a good day.